Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to Ahkam SOS, the show that discusses Islamic duties and practices for Muslims by His Eminence, the Grand Ayatollah Sayyid Sadiq Shirazi. May Allah prolong his life. I'm your host, Mohsin Shah, and joining me is Sheikh Ali Ma. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikhna.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi.
How are you?
Alhamdulillah. Okay.
MashaAllah. Sheikhna, we know that sujood is one of the rukuns of salah. How does one actually perform sujood?
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين Let me begin with a verse in the Holy Quran with regard to the sujood and to narrations from Ahl al-Bayt عليهم السلام. The Holy Quran states with regard to the sujood, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اركعوا واسجدوا واعبدوا ربكم. The verse states that all you who believe, bow down, prostrate, and worship your Lord. It is an instruction from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is an order, it's a wajib, that the one does the ruku' and sujood and worship his Lord. That's wajib. That's an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's the first issue with regard to the sujood. The hadiths from Imam Al-Kadhim alayhi salam, where he says to one of the Shia followers, when the Imam was in prison in Baghdad, a man writes to the Imam alayhi salam a letter asking him for his difficulties, calamities, anxieties. So the Imam alayhi salam responds back with a letter telling him what to do and to read a dua in which state. And the Imam tells him to read the dua in the state of sujood. So he says to him, إِذَا صَلَّيْتَ فَأَطِلِ السُّجُودِ. When you pray, make sure that you extend your sujood, you prolong your sujood in that state. And you read such and such in the dua. So one of the ways in which you can get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you get in that state of humbleness and humiliation before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in the state of sujood. And that is one of the best positions and states in which the one can be in worship. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi had stated, جُعِلَتْ لِيَ الْأَرْضُ مَسْجِدًا وَطَهُورًا.
Okay.
So the earth is a place where you prostrate, mm-hmm. you do the sujood, and you purify yourself, tahura, i.e. tayammum.
Yes.
When you have no means of water, mm-hmm. access to water to do the ghusl or the wudu. So these are the hadith and verse in which speaks about the sujood and its importance and its wajib being in salah. With regard to your question about how do you perform the sujood, it is mandatory and wajib after the one who performed the ruku' to stand upright, motionless, and mustahab to say Sami'a Allah liman hamidah, and then head for the sujood.
Okay.
You must be in that state. You cannot head for the sujood while you're in ruku'. So imagine you're in ruku' and you go to sujood straight away.
So the qiyam,
salah will be batil.
There's a qiyam before sujood that
exactly.
is necessary.
Qiyam before, exactly, to be upright before the sujood, that's wajib. You must mm-hmm. be in that state before heading for the sujood. Otherwise, if you neglect it, you leave it, then the salah will be batil, as I've said. So from the ruku', you must stand up upright, and then you head for the sujood. That's one issue in regard to performing the sujood. The other issue is that we have two sujood. So the first sajda mm-hmm. and then the second sajda, they're both are wajib. Now there is something else between the two sajda. You have to sit up between the two sajda, and that, as the Sayyid says, it is mandatory to sit up after the first sajda to have a rest for 2 seconds, let's say, and then you go back to sajda, the second sajda. That sitting is required, is mandatory between the two sajda. So you sit up 2 seconds, 3 seconds, and then you go back for the second sajda.
Shekhna, how far would you sit up? Because sometimes I've seen people going to sujood, they quickly they get up, and they don't fully go to the, you know, to the extent where they're sitting down again. So they'll get up and go back down. Is this acceptable?
The Sayyid says you have to attain a state of motionlessness. That's important. Okay. So you have to sit up and with motionless, and then you go back. Complete sit up.
We need a full extension.
Exactly.
You sit on your knees.
Exactly. Exactly.
Until you've and stationary. Be stationary.
Exactly.
And then go into your second.
You go back to the second sujood. Okay. That's wajib. The other issue with the sujood, similar to the ruku', you say Subhanallah 3 times. Again, Subhanallah, Subhanallah, Subhanallah. Exactly like the ruku', and also similar to the ruku' as well. You say Subhana Rabbi al-A'la wa bihamdih. That's the difference, just one word. Mm-hmm. In ruku' we say Subhana Rabbi al-Azimi wa bihamdih. Here in sujood we say Subhana Rabbi al-A'la wa bihamdih. Just one word difference. And exactly the same as the ruku', you have to continue between the words of the sujood. So Subhana Rabbi.
Yes, continuation. No long breaks between the words.
Exactly. And to stay in correct Arabic. Mm-hmm. And as well, as we mentioned last episode, that you can mention them 3 times, 5 times, 7 times, and upwards.
Okay.
Mustahab to mention the sujood, Subhana Rabbi al-A'la wa bihamdih, 3 times, three or times. 5 or 7, odd numbers. Odd numbers, exactly. It is also mustahab, like the ruku' and in the sujood as well, after mentioning the wajib dhikr of the sujood, to say Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Very rewarding. And it's important to mention it to give you more blessings and thawab in the salah.
Ahsan. Shaykhna, we know that, you know, sujood is a rukun. It's your salah is batil without the sujood. Lakin, is it one sujood or both sujood, you know, such that is considered to be the rukun?
Sujood of 2 sajda, okay. Not 1 sajda. Both sajda mm-hmm. are rukun and key elements of the salah. So you have to make sure that it's not the 1 sajda only. Both sajda, they are counted as rukun and key elements. And if somebody intentionally or unintentionally does not perform the 2 sajda together, let's say somebody in the last rak'ah, he goes from heads for to sit after the ruku'. He sits and he does tashahud straight away, mm-hmm. no 2 sajda. He forgets. Yeah. And when he finishes the salah, he remembers that I missed 2 sajda, the salah will be void and batil. Although he forgot, unintentional. But because it's a key element and rukun, he has to redo the salah.
Oh, redo the salah.
Repeat it,
wow.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. That's rukun, so he must be careful not to leave such an important
similarly
element.
To the ruku'. Do I have to be in a state of motionlessness in sujood? For example, if I'm going into sujood, can I start the dhikr before I go into sujood? Just before my head touches the turba or the wood piece or whatever. Can I start to recite Subhanallah, Subhanallah, Subhanallah?
If one intentionally and deliberately begins to say the words of the dhikr of the sujood before his forehead reaching the ground, the turba, or vice versa, while he is reading and saying the dhikr of the sujood, he raises his head. So let's say I'm going towards the sujood, and before reaching the sujood, the turba, I say Subhanallah. So the first Subhanallah, it's on the way, yes, towards the ground. Mm-hmm. And the second Subhanallah is on the turba, and the third Subhanallah the while turba. I'm moving out,
oh, okay. Oh, wow.
and leaving the turba. Imagine how quick, and unfortunately some people might do it. In this case, because it's intentional, the salah will be batil and void. Mm-hmm. So we have to give enough time and be motionless and stationary, yes, in all the acts of salah, and especially the sujood, that you first, you put your forehead on the turba first, on the ground, you rest the forehead there, then you begin the dhikr, subhanallah, or subhanallah, rabbil azim, ala wa bihamdih, and then you raise your head from the ground, and then you continue your salah.
Okay.
You must make sure that you are in a state of motionless. That's important. Otherwise, the salah will be batil.
MashaAllah, you know, it's very important that we get our timing right, not to start the dhikr too early, mashaAllah. Sheikhna, what about when I'm in sujood and, you know, I've got body parts on the ground? Am I actually allowed to, you know, move any of the body parts, my hand, for example, or my foot? And if I'm not allowed, what does one do in that case?
Initially, we have something which is called al-masajid al-sab'a, the seven positions and parts of the body in which they are wajib and mandatory to be on the ground while performing the sujood. And they are the forehead, the two palms, and the knees, both knees, and the big toes of the feet.
Okay.
They must be on the floor, on the ground, while performing the sajda.
So when you say toes, do you mean as in they have to be flat on the ground, or like the tips have to touch?
Yeah, tips on the
The nail doesn't have to
ground.
Touch. It should be the tips.
The tips, yeah, okay. Yeah. In overall, so they are wajib to be on the ground while performing the sujood. Now, if somebody moves his hand out of sudden, unintentional, or one of his feet, for example, other than the whole forehead, the forehead has its own hukum.
Okay.
It's just the other body parts. If it was unintentional, then he should keep silent and bring back the hand or the foot and repeat the ayah that, or whatever he read in the sajda, the dua or the ayah or anything else, and to repeat it in that state, motionless state. If it's deliberate, then of course the salah will be batil. You cannot raise any of these masajid from the ground deliberately, because it will make the salah void and batil.
Ahsan, thank you very much, Sheikhna. But Sheikhna, what about the forehead? If that, you know, comes off the ground before my sujood has finished, can I put my forehead back on the ground?
As I've mentioned now, other than the forehead, anything you raise from the ground unintentionally, you have to put it back and redo the dhikr of the sujood, except the forehead. The forehead is the core and the main for the sujood. If unintentionally the forehead was raised, you're not allowed to put it back.
Oh.
In this case, this will be counted as one sujood, even if you have not uttered or said anything. But because you've just unintentionally you removed your head from the sajda and you haven't finished or you haven't even said anything, that one sajda will be counted.
Okay.
And you cannot redo the sajda in order, for example, to say the words of sujood or to complete the sajda saying. So there's no way you can put your head back again and redo the sajda better.
So you should just carry on your prayer?
Just carry on, and that's counted as one sajda.
So if it comes off, if your forehead for some reason is removed from the ground, sit up.
Exactly.
Recite your dhikr if you have to.
Exactly.
And go into the second sajda.
It's counted one full sajda, khalas.
Okay.
You move to the next sajda, second sajda, and then?
Is there any kafara or any penalty?
Nothing at all, nothing at all. It's just unintentional, that's fine.
Okay, so it's, yeah. Alhamdulillah, it's counted for.
Exactly.
MashaAllah, thank you very much, Sheikh. Thank you to all our viewers joining us today on Ahkam SOS. MashaAllah, you've seen with sujood the importance of reciting the dhikr on time. Make sure you're not too early with the dhikr, not too late. And also, you know, we see the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that if you're in sujood and for, you know, unintentionally your forehead is taken off the ground, you can carry on your prayer and there's nothing, no harm done. MashaAllah, what a beautiful religion this is. Thank you for joining us, and inshallah you can join us on the next episode of Ahkam SOS here on Imam Hussein TV. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.